Welcome. So today's video is going to be special, and it is in honor of PM Modi coming to America. And the title of this video is amazing. It says Howdy Modi Gala at Houston along with US President Donald Trump. And then it says, is Trump aiming for massive vote bank? And there's a question mark in there. So yes, guys, if you don't know, Prime Minister Modi is coming to US, America on 22nd September. He'll be in Houston where he'll be meeting all the Indian Americans. And everyone here is excited. And this video is going to give us a general idea of what's going on and what the excitement is all about. And let's just simply jump into this video and have some fun. And yes, friends, make sure you watch this video till the very end, because the best part is in the end.
This information had been in the air for a while now, but there was no official confirmation. Today, the US Press Department officially announced that American President Donald Trump will share the stage with India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the Houston, Texas.
Yeah, with Trump, nothing is confirmed, but we'll see.
Now, you'd remember what happened in Madison Square Garden, New York. You'd remember what happened at the Wembley Stadium in London. This is going to be bigger.
Bigger than that.
Never before in the United States has any international leader, except if you count the Pope an international leader, but definitely no political leader, would have pulled off a show of strength of this sort. 60,000 Indian Americans chanting Modi, Modi, and the US president on the same stage with him.
Wow.
The world will watch, especially Islamabad and Beijing. This is our lead story tonight.
US President Donald Trump will join Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Howdy Modi, or How Do You Do Modi event at the sprawling NRG Stadium in Texas, United States, on the 22nd of September.
Narendra Damodar Das Modi.
White House on Monday confirmed that Trump will share the dais with the Prime Minister at Texas. In a statement, the White House press secretary said, "It will be a great opportunity to emphasize the strong ties."
That's the same photo of which I keep telling I love when he patted his hand.
The strategic partnership between the world's oldest and largest democracies, and to discuss ways to deepen their energy and trade relationship, unquote. Prime Minister Narendra Modi too tweeted saying, "Usher by the President of the United States, signifying the special friendship between India and USA. Delighted that President Donald Trump will join the community program at Houston on the 22nd. Looking forward to joining the Indian origin community."
Indian origin community, that's us.
The program. The special gesture of the US President to join us in Houston highlights the strength of the relationship and recognition of the contribution of the Indian community.
Contribution of Indian community.
American society and economy.
Contribution of Indian community.
The high point of Indian diplomacy, in the sense that President Donald Trump, who is, you know, he's very selective about meeting world leaders.
Yeah.
His meeting with Prime Minister Modi, and that too not one but three or four meetings, and he's meeting him in a public gathering with 50,000 Indians present there, American Indians present there. Has its own significance.
This will be the first time that the Indian Prime Minister and the US President will be addressing such a huge gathering of Indian Americans together. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has addressed the Indian diaspora twice in the past in the US. The first time at the Madison Square Garden in New York in 2014.
I was in California.
At the Silicon Valley, California in 2016.
My dream is to become a $20 trillion economy.
Wow!
But this is the largest gathering of approximately 50,000 Indian Americans together.
50,000.
The earlier two gatherings were approximately 20,000 people.
Oh, so this time it's going to be double the gathering.
More than double.
The largest gathering for any foreign dignitary in the U.S. after the Pope.
After the Pope, this is the largest gathering.
Maybe the next one will be bigger than the Pope.
Presidential elections. Donald Trump had addressed a gathering of approximately 5,000 Indian Americans in New Jersey and came up with the tagline, अब की बार ट्रंप सरकार
He's speaking just like Rishi.
A foreign affairs editor, Geeta Mohan. Geeta, this would have been a coup to pull off. To have, you know, we wanted to get Barack Obama for the Republic Day parade. That didn't work out here. Modi saying, okay, you've got an election next year. I'll give you Indian Americans cheering for you.
Absolutely. And it's a two-way stream, Rahul. It's not just a one plus for Modi. More so, it is what President Trump has to achieve out of this big event. Imagine 50,000 Indian Americans could Trump team have managed to get such a huge gathering.
Who speaks first?
Who speaks first? Modi will be speaking first in all probability, but
it really doesn't matter, right?
Doesn't matter who speaks first.
The Democrats are also going to be represented in this.
So Democrats are also going to be.
If you were in Washington at this moment, this would be a nightmare. Who speaks first? Who speaks longer?
Doesn't matter.
Prime Minister Modi is used to having the attention focused.
I mean, Indian Americans are both. So it doesn't matter.
Donald Trump, the biggest showman politician in the world. How do you think this is likely to shape up? Will this be a massive show of strength for our Prime Minister in this country?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yes. Because Indian Americans are coming.
It's a considerable diplomatic achievement on the part of our Prime Minister and on the part of India.
Yeah.
To have such an event where a
share dreams bright future.
Present. But if you ask me, how would I be, supposing I was as a diplomat in America, which indeed I was, but 30 years ago, I would keep my fingers crossed precisely for the reason that you mentioned. It is a fact that the president can be a little unpredictable, a little difficult to read at times, but notwithstanding that, it is a coup.
This is from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. on 22nd.
Ever such an event in which a U.S. president has participated.
How did you pull it off? What happened behind the scenes and what sort of spectacle will we expect in Houston, Texas?
Rahul, we should not see it as a partisan event and coup for BJP. It is a matter of pride for every Indian and every Indian American that U.S. president is coming. So we should see it in the larger context.
Is there a political rally in Texas as big as this before?
I don't think so.
Modi, what are the locals telling you? I know that the Pope has done something bigger, but has any politician, American politician, let alone global politician, done something like this?
I really doubt if such a big political rally has ever taken place in Texas or even in Houston. Of course, during the inauguration ceremony, when the American president is taking place, there are hundreds of thousands of people that turn up.
But that's a special case.
There is becoming a president. Here we are talking about just a speech.
But not by normal circumstances and definitely not by any foreign leader.
Not by any foreign leader.
Dr. Trivedi, I remember being in Davos at the World Economic Forum last year when Donald Trump was supposed to come. Now, I won't name who, but the senior-most leadership of WEF had absolutely no idea.
Will he come or he won't be coming? Everyone is confused.
He physically landed. They weren't certain that he's going to come. He also extended an invitation, as we now know, to the Taliban leadership to come to Camp David. And at the last moment changed his mind.
He is arguably the most mercurial,
unpredictable politician in the world.
Rahul, you said correct. But there is a significant difference in the situation today. Before the Modi government, the diplomacy of our country was mainly focusing on just two aspects, the strategic aspect and the economic aspect, the trade and commerce and the military interest. But after Modi ji assumed power, he has used two more dimensions, which were never used by the previous governments. One was a cultural diplomacy, the huge cultural impact of India. When a strong Indian diaspora is available all over the world, why it should not be used properly in the interest of India? Particularly in the United States, you know that the Indian community is now the most educated community in US, surpassing Jews a couple of years back. Now, they constitute around more than 1% of the population. And with the influence, they are having much more bigger influence. So in my opinion, this is not just an expression of the people of Indian origin in favor of Shri Narendra Modi, but an expression of the dexterous diplomatic capability of Shri Narendra Modi, which is showing their strength even in the internal domestic politics of US.
US.
As
right.
my friend Chautai Walaji was saying, that is still it's not very clear that how many congressmen, governors and others are coming, but one thing is very clear, that US president might have not seen, other than the swearing-in ceremony, such a huge crowd.
Wow!
So in my opinion, this is a milestone, in the new dimension of Indian diplomacy that is based on diaspora.
That is true.
And obviously, this is
going all
to
the people here from India will always fight for India. That's a good thing. Yeah.
I also like to remind, in 1993, when it was 100th year of Swami Vivekananda, our organizations have organized a program and we were unable to get even a single US congressman. That was the stature of India. And now the US president is coming in a program which is organized by an Indian community and others. I think this is a huge paradigm shift in the power structure of India in the last 25 years. So this is a proud moment for every Indian.
Absolutely.
And Indian American.
Can be no ego bigger than that of Donald Trump. He'll be in Texas and 50,000, maybe 60,000 Indian Americans will be shouting, Modi, Modi! How's he going to take that?
That's a good point. I think that Trump has been assured that he's going to have plenty of time as well. And I'm sure that you'll hear at some point cheers of Trump, Trump as well. And that's what he would want. Mm-hmm. Just a few points on this. I mean, I agree with what we said, that this really is a big deal. And this Howdy Modi event will literally be twice as big as the Madison Square Garden event a few years back, just because this NRG Stadium in Houston is a football arena that holds about 70,000 people, whereas the Madison Square Garden is a basketball and hockey arena, holds about 25,000. So we're hearing there could be 50,000, maybe even more people.
So like three event. Times
That's
more.
That's already a big deal. Second point is that, yes, it is a coup for India to get Trump to come to this event, but Trump is a transactional guy, and
That's a good point.
You know, he was more likely to do this once he heard that there was going to be a lot in it for him. And one is the domestic political benefits for Trump. He's going to be doing this event in a very key political state, Texas, and he's going to have an opportunity to make an appeal to a key political constituency in the United States, and that's the very large and growing Indian American community.
You know, it's just Geeta, the spectacle that they're able to create from Madison Square Garden, Wembley, constantly thinking of new things, and this is just going to take the cake.
Absolutely, Rahul, and like Ambassador Kachu said, this is one of the most important foreign policy toolkits for the Modi administration.
And it's a big strength,
absolutely,
which was never utilized and leveraged.
Never utilized.
It was, of course. Not in this fashion. They're all charged up. We've already received lots of messages saying, hey, are you coming, etc.
So just to get the numbers right, 50,000 already registered, 8,000.
Oh, now it's 8,000.
About
5,000 before.
Probably go 60 plus if they're now.
The moment they know Trump's coming,
those are waiting lists, so no more are allowed.
Yeah, so I think they want to keep some
reserve. I understand that, of course. And I think Mikey Google was an important point. They want to hear some Trump, and they're going to be very happy. They're all just chanting Modi. But Indian Americans, so their loyalty is, you know, they love India, but they're also American national. That's where they're getting their bread and butter from. I want to show you some excerpts of Prime Minister Modi's previous forays. He started, of course, with Madison Square, Wembley, Sydney, went to California in 2016. So he's been out and about. He ended that towards the latter part of his first term. But now that he's into a new term, again in the driver's seat, this is going to be one of the biggest shows that's been seen in a long while.
True. Oh, wow.
In a true rock star style, he stopped
rock star style.
Crowd that had come to witness him speak.
People are going crazy.
Yeah, people are going crazy like a rock star.
At a completely packed Madison Square Garden.
It is true. People will go.
To the US,
people are going and people want to see him.
The chants of Bharat Mata Ki Jai and Modi Modi. He wasn't just selling the idea of India to the Americans or the NRIs, but also making a statement to the Indian voters as people back home stayed glued to their TV screen.
They also stayed glued to the TV.
Watching their PM become a rage on
foreign shores. People are crazy. They're crazy.
हमारे देश की युवा पीढ़ी ना होती इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी के क्षेत्र में आप लोगों ने जो कमाल
चलो
तो आज भी दुनिया शायद हमें सात सपेरों वालों का ही
देश ओह दे वुड हैव थॉट अस अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल सीन
इन एनी कंट्री यू गो एंड यू सी द क्लीनलीनेस ऑफ
न्यूजीलैंड लग
रहा था सबसे पहले मुझे
याद आते कि नहीं
ओह ओह मेड इन इंडिया
बहुत अच्छा अगर ये वहां पे डांस भी करेगा बॉलीवुड
चाहिए बस मेड इन इंडिया
हिप्नोटिक ड्रमिंग
Wow!
And the crowd chanting his name. Understandably, the PM is more garrulous at such gatherings than he can ever be in Parliament. And soon, he speaks his heart out.
Oh, wow!
Very nice.
Very nice.
Video. And it is true that most of the Indian Americans will be going primarily to see Mr. Modi, and they'll be, you know, want to see the Prime Minister and
hear his beautiful speech because he's so good in
speeches.
He's
so good in speaking. You're right.
Yeah. So they are basically going to,
just to see him
and meet him and hear him speak.
Yeah.
And chant his name, Modi, 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 because everyone is very excited. I mean, all Indian Americans are very excited.
Right.
So yeah, but unfortunately, we can't go. But we, just like, you know, you guys will be glued to the TV watching this. We'll be also glued on the TV and watching it live, yes. So this is very exciting. And I mean, he said such beautiful things about Indian Americans.
Yeah.
And that is true, guys.
Right.
So, I mean, as we said, we have a fantastic leader who knows how to, you know, make everyone walk along with him.
Yeah.
In this path of making India great.
Right.
So amazing, amazing, amazing.
Very nice video. And we are just waiting anxiously. It's probably just a few days.
When this just one day more left,
yeah,
guys.
It's gonna,
yeah.
Take place. And then we really want to see what he says. And looking at the Bollywood presentation will be a fantastic thing.
I think they're going to have some kind of dance or something, just like they had it in Madison Square.
Right.
So probably they're also arranging something like that for this occasion. And plus, this is like 3 times more than the previous one. So it's going to be
much more
massive.
Yeah. That's why they're saying he's going to be a real rock star.
Yeah.
With 60,000 people.
Chanting
and,
Modi.
It's okay, Mr. Trump is going to come. That's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because then maybe many people will feel like giving to Mr. Trump. That has yet to be seen. Because if people see that Trump is a friend of India, then mostly Indian Americans will give to him. Because Mr. Trump has said many things in his life. But if he comes in there, I think there will be some positive factor.
Yes.
And it's also true that the state of Texas was Republican, but slowly it is going Democratic.
Mm.
And the Democratic leaders are also going to come. I think they may not get an opportunity to speak. Which it appears they may not.
So it was before you said was Republican.
It is,
now becoming Democratic,
yeah.
Or is it the other way around?
No. So Texas was always Republican, but slowly now it is getting Democratic.
Oh, I see.
Now to maintain the Republican stronghold, then Mr. Trump is
trying
to say, okay,
to...
at least I'll get many voters towards
but
him.
But it's a good sign. I mean, his coming is a sign of friendship between India
that
and America.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, end of the day.
And it really helps the Indians who are living here. So.
Exactly. I mean, all the Indian Americans have somebody in there in India.
Yes.
So they would always want something good with India. And if they see a president who is kind of willing to work with Indian Americans and says good things about them, they will most likely vote to him because their interest is that no harm should come to India.
Yep.
So I think that is what they are trying to do. But as I said, I mean, we or anyone would be more interested in seeing Mr. Modi speak and listen to him and, you know, see the Bollywood show or whatever, you know, cultural activities they have planned.
Yes. And guys, this is going to happen on Sunday, 22nd. And as it said, it's going to be from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So, but I mean, latest we've heard that there's a lot of rain
and Houston,
floods also. So we are keeping our fingers crossed that, you know, this thing, it doesn't get cancelled because there, I mean, everybody, all Indian Americans, and I'm sure even Indians in India are looking forward to seeing Mr. Modi come here and, you know, talk and give his speech. So fingers are crossed that, you know, it doesn't get cancelled and we are lucky enough to watch him and hear him.
Yeah.
So guys, very exciting. And We'll now end this vlog and we'll come back again with another video pretty soon. Till then, take care and bye-bye.
Oh, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so it notifies you when I put in my new video for you to enjoy. Bye!